We'll begin today's session with an introduction of EAC, and then our technical account manager and Windchill expert, Bill Schlund, will talk us through how to search in PTC's Windchill. For those of you who do not know who we are, I'll start off with a quick introduction to EAC. Our mission is to transform the way companies design, manufacture, connect to, and service their product. We are not only a value-added reseller for PTC, but we are the number one solutions provider for PTC in the country, something that we're very proud of. We have experts in 22 areas of product development and are located all over the U.S. with our headquarters in Burnsville, Minnesota. We offer our customers everything they need for product development, such as service lifecycle management software, which helps you to create and manage service documentation, product data management software like Windchill, ThingWorks Navigate, and our customizable EAC productivity apps, which help you to manage internal product data. We implement the Internet of Things and augmented reality into business strategies to jumpstart initiatives around digital transformation and connecting to things in your company. We assist with design and engineering products like FEA, simulation, reverse engineering, and proof of concepts for our customers. And we offer webinars and PTC certified training courses for continuous learning. We are also a commercial reseller for Form Labs, offering the Form 2, which is a SLA 3D printer that delivers high resolution parts and prototypes for as low as $3,500. So please keep us in mind. We really have a variety of tools to help your organization save money and time throughout the product development process. And our job is to help you excel at what you already know how to do best. Today, though, Bill will be running us through his agenda of what we'll cover. Go ahead, Bill.
Thanks, Jess. Good morning, everybody. Thanks for attending. We'll be going through creating and uploading documents in Windchill, working with various types of documents, and then checking in and checking out documents. So mostly I'm going to be revolving around documents because they behave a little bit differently than typical kind of Windchill. So let me share my screen with you here. And right now I have Windchill. I'm working on Windchill 11, and I'm going to be working in this folder here. I have a couple of documents already here, or I should say CAD documents. I have a drawing and a part here, but what we want to do is talk about other types of documents. So typically, if I were to check out a CAD part, it doesn't matter whether it's Creo or SolidWorks, Annex, or whoever, it checks it out to a workspace, right? So it checks it out from the server to a local area on my local computer, right? Usually on my C drive or wherever. Documents are a little bit different. It doesn't check them out to workspace, but it does check them out and place them locally on your computer. So that's kind of a little bit of the difference there. But let's kind of go through some of that and see how that works. So the first thing I'm going to do is here I can go and create a document. Also, the same command is obviously under here, where I can say create a new document. But we'll say, let's create a document. And then, you know, what type of document is this going to be? Again, this will be something that we can search on by type, but I'll say a document here. In this case, I'm going to say, let's use a template. So there can be a series of templates that you can use, in this case, for a Word document, that will be like a form that I can fill in. So I'm going to say a memo template. And we'll give this a name like CDEF or something like that. And I'll say finish. So that adds the document here. Now, because I used a template, it automatically checked it out for me because it figures you're going to want to fill in the document. So I'm going to say, let's take a look at this guy. I'll just say, let's open it in the folder. And it pops up this folder here. And here I can see the document. So just double click, and it's under downloads. So here's another little kind of a nuance, I guess. Depending on how your system is set up, for instance, the login I'm using right now, when I download something or when I check it out, it puts it under my PC under downloads. But sometimes you might see a file here called data.wcdti or something like that. And basically, it's a link to your documents folder, which would be right here on your drive. And it'll place it under there. It'll use the same name. It'll create a folder with your server name. And then underneath there, it'll have a folder called checkouts, and you'll find it in there. So depending on how your system is set up, you might get the folder or get the file directly under your downloads, or you might have like a link here that you click on. It would just go under documents and pull it up for you. But if I were to open this guy up now, and we can take a look at him here, here's the form that I would go and fill in, right? So I could fill this in, save it, and then check it back in, and it would bump it up to, you know, version 2. So let's continue on. So I'm going to just say undo checkout for this guy for right now. Now, the next thing I want to do is I want to go in and kind of the same thing. I'm going to say create a document, but this time I'm not going to use a template. So now it says I can browse for a file, right? So I can browse on my drive anywhere I want. The reason I have everything kind of moved over here on the side is so that I could just drag and drop things, make it a little bit easier. So here I have an Excel spreadsheet. I drag and drop it in there. It adds it, and then I'll say I'm finished. So you notice in this case, here's my Excel spreadsheet. It didn't check it out, right? Because I'm dragging in a document that it already has. So let's look at another option that we have under here. So basically, we've just covered kind of the first one, but two different flavors, right? Using a template and not using a template. Then there is new multiple documents. So if I do that, we get a window. And again, it's going to be the same type of questions. You know, what type of document is this going to be? Then I'm going to say, let's go in and add a document, right? So attach a new local file. And I'm going to search, in this case, on my desktop, and we'll find a PowerPoint. So let's add that in there. So that's added that in. I can also drag and drop, right? So because it is multiple documents, I only got one right now. So I'm going to say, let's go in and add an Excel to this, and let's add a PDF. So now I have three different documents, and I can also specify which folders I want them to be placed in. You know, by default, it's going to put them in the current directory that I am in, but again, I can ship those out to other places. So upon saying okay, we'll notice that all those documents now have been added to my folder. Now there's another option over here when we went under new for documents, and it's called upload documents from a compressed file, right? From a zip file. So kind of how that works, I have a folder right here on my desktop, right? So I'm going to open it up so we can take a peek at it. But this folder is sort of a folder structure, right? So it's for vendor ABC. But under there, we have a folder for documents. I have a folder for drawings. I have a TIFF file under there. Under CAD, I have mechanical and electrical files under there. But you can see it's a whole CAD structure that we have here. So what I've done is I've taken that structure and I've zipped it up. And so that's this zip file that we see right here. So this is where I'm going to, when it go and say upload files from a compressed file, it will be from this guy. So let's go through and do that. Again, I'm going to browse for the zip file that I have here. And here it is, right? So it's on my desktop. It's this guy. Say open this up. Now what it does is does not bring in the whole folder structure. What it does is it strips out all the documents in that folder structure and uploads those. So I'll say, let's bring that one in. And what type of documents are these gonna be? We'll just say regular documents, can put in some descriptions, and we'll say okay. So I did have this up earlier. But what this would do is go in and put in a reference of all these parts that I've uploaded here and add those to our folder structure here. So we'll kind of cancel out of there. So another thing that I want to do is talk about integration. So one of the things we can do here is I'm going to go over to my quick links and say software downloads. And so what I can do is download. If you do the workgroup managers net, you always have to download that from ptc.com now as of release 11. But here I can download Office integration, right? So 32 or 64-bit Office integration software. So what that gives us, if I pop up a Word document here, here I have a Word document, have the regular folders that we're used to seeing, but there's a Windchill folder that automatically gets attached, not just for Word, but for any of the Office products. So we can see that here. Here's my Word document. I can check it in. I can open up other documents inside of Windchill. I can connect or disconnect from the server here. So all the capabilities basically that I was using before are right here. So I can apply those to Windchill. So let's take a look at we've been looking at files that Windchill recognizes, right? You can see this is a PDF, this is an Excel, it understands those. But what if I use something that isn't part of Office integration, right? So I'm gonna go in and create a different type of file and we're gonna upload that. So let's go in and say, new file. And again, as we've been doing so far, we'll just say it's just a regular document. But this time I'm going to drag in a file that Windchill doesn't really know about, right? So this is, I'm using Creo Sketch, right? Free download. But I'm just going to go and drag and drop that in there. And we'll say, let's add that as a document. So there's not a workgroup manager for Creo Sketch or anything like that. So you'll notice that the representation, the little icon they put here is saying download unknown, right? It's an unknown type of file, whereas the other ones all have recognizable types. So for this particular one, if I wanted to go and edit it, what I would do, another option that I have that we haven't used yet, is I could say check out and download. So not only am I going to check it out, but I'm going to download it. So I'll say check out and download. And we'll say, let's save it to our folder. Here's our downloads folder. Let's kind of switch our, here's our file right here. So it's a hairdryer. So this is the one, I can double click on it. Now, in this particular case, Windows recognizes this type of file, so it'll open it up. But if it doesn't, you know, you could call up the other software that created this and open it that way. But Windows does recognize this. Here's our Creo Sketch file. This is of a hairdryer. And I'm gonna say, all right, so it's, I don't know, blowing out some air or something like that. And we'll say, let's save this. Let's say file. Now, if I say file exit, it'll say, do you want to save it? And I'll say yes. So that saves it, it updates it. So now we minimize this guy. As he is checked out, I can just right mouse button and say check in. And then we can just browse for that particular guy, which is under downloads. And here it is. I'll just say use that new version. That's our updated version. This is going to bump it up to version A2. See, we can see this is now A2. And if I were to open this up, we'd see like the little hot air coming out of that. So the next thing I want to talk about is editing a document. This is kind of a roundabout way of doing things. But I can edit a document without checking it out. So so let's give that a shot here. So I'm gonna say, let's create a new document. And we'll just pull in some other file here. So drag this guy in. So now he's been added and you notice he's not checked out. So one of the things I'm going to want to do is make some changes to it. So one of the things that's interesting in here is I can say download primary file, right? So download this file. I'll say save it and we can open it up. And let's get our, here's our Word that I changed. So I'm just gonna call him up. Pops it over here. I'm gonna say enable editing. And you know, I can type in some stuff, you know, for trucks only. And save this. So now I've downloaded it to my downloads folder. Now we can see it here, the updated version. And now it's not checked out. But what I can do is go in here and I can say that I want to replace the content, right? Replace the content of that folder. And we can browse. Here's our rugged truck version. I can say, okay, and this will bump it up to version 2. So basically, I updated this guy without ever checking it out. Right? So it's kind of a roundabout way. It's still going to bump it up a release or up a version. But the thing is that, let's say you uploaded a file and it wasn't the correct file. You can say replace the content. It just pulls the whole first file out and replaces it with the second file. So technically, that's what I did. But what I did is I really updated the first file to add some extra text in it and then uploaded it that way. But sort of a way of working with a file without ever checking it out. So I just thought that was kind of an interesting way of getting about it and also using some functionality that's here in Windchill. And then since we're doing things that are kind of weird, I want to add a document without a web browser, right? So I'm going to come over here to my Windows Explorer and say, let's open this up. So now I have Windows Explorer up here, right? Not using my web browser at all. And I'll say, let's go to this PC. Let's go to Windchill Documents. And I'll say iCenter. I can go to Products. So I'm browsing through right now our really our common space while I'm in Windows Explorer here. So under this, I'm going to go under the folder that we've been at so far. So here are all those files that I've been creating. And now if I want to add a new document in here, I just drag and drop it in here. It's going to ask me the exact same questions as if I would say file new. So I'm just going to say, let's create this as a document and say, okay. And now that's been added. We can see it added right here. And if we go back to our browser here, and refresh him, we will see that it's been added to that as well, right here. All right. So sort of a couple different unique ways of getting information into Windchill or modifying information aside from the typical check-in and check-out. And that's kind of bringing us to the end of our tips and techniques section.